Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. Thanks for clicking on this video, I appreciate it as always. I am back in LA as y'all saw in my last video. I'm here with Em.
Hi guys.
And we are going to take you through our full leg and glute workout. I know the last video that you saw of us was also legs and glutes. I swear we train other body parts. I just trained shoulders the other day, Em just trained back, and we'll make sure to get an upper body vlog for you guys before I leave LA again. But today we're training legs and glutes, and this is gonna be a voiceover since you guys really liked the last one and I got lots of good feedback. So let me know again if you want more voiceovers or if you like edits like I did last time better, just let me know. But in the meantime, enjoy the workout. Hey everyone, I am back for another voiceover. I got some really good feedback on the last one, so I thought I'd do another one, but this time a leg workout with Emily Hayden. So I'm just gonna walk you through everything we did, starting with a little clip of our warm-up. We were just doing dynamic stretches, lunges, Frankenstein walks, etc. We also did some leg swings and other dynamic stretches. Just do whatever helps you feel warm and prepared to lift. The first exercise of this workout were top half sumo deadlifts. This gym did not have bumper plates, so we chose to do our deadlifts on the Smith machine this day, and we chose to do the top half of the movement because this hits your glutes better and is also nice if you don't have very good hip mobility like myself and Emily. Emily Duncan posted a leg workout recently and she reminded me how awesome this movement is. It seriously kills your glutes if you squeeze at the top, so you'll notice that at the top of each rep, I kind of pause and make sure that my glutes are fully squeezed and fully clenched. And this is just a friendly reminder that if you are working your glutes correctly, it's not gonna look pretty. Your glutes are gonna look ugly, but ugly butt in the gym means juicy butt out of the gym. You may have noticed that my grip was kind of failing the last few reps of the last set. So for the next set, I chose to use some lifting straps since I care more about building my glutes right now rather than my grip strength. If I was more focused on grip strength, I would focus more on lifting without straps and not relying on those, but my goals right now mean that I can use some straps in order to get a better glute contraction and maintain better form. Other things to remember when doing this exercise are to sit back, pull the bar into your shins, and keep your back straight. Also, with a sumo deadlift, you want to try to remain a little more upright than you would with a conventional deadlift. And like I said earlier, make sure you're really squeezing the glutes at the top. We did four sets here, working up to 225, and then we moved on to our second exercise, which was a single leg press, and we laid at an angle so that we could hit the side of our glutes a little better. This might be a little tricky for some people as far as staying pain-free and executing it properly, so don't be afraid to just do it straight on with a single leg, but I really like doing single leg press because it prevents you from favoring one side over the other and makes sure that your unilateral strength or your strength on each side by itself is the same rather than letting imbalances develop by doing both legs at the same time. With this exercise and leg pressing in general, you want to keep your feet high on the platform in order to target your glutes if that is what you're targeting. And then you'll also notice for this, I stayed kind of twisted around for most of the reps, and that just allowed a greater range of motion on my working leg rather than running into my body and having to stop right away. Don't be afraid to play around with foot and body placement so that you feel it where you should be feeling it and that you stay pain-free. Experimentation is totally fine, so don't be afraid to play around with it and find what works best for you. Next up, we moved on to barbell good mornings. We worked up to 65 pounds. We were decently fatigued from our deadlifts and leg press already, so we didn't go terribly heavy since we wanted to keep our form good. But the keys to this exercise are to keep your spine and neck neutral. So if you notice, as I bend, my head bends the same way. I'm not craning my neck up. That puts a lot of strain on your neck. But just keep the barbell in a high bar squat position, and then you will hinge at the hips, loading the hamstrings, and then squeeze your glutes when you're all the way down and use your glutes to propel you to stand up, and then squeeze at the top. One cue that really helps me during this exercise is to try to initiate the movement by activating my glutes at the bottom. So right here, I would think squeeze glutes and then finish at the top. Squeeze and push through. This is primarily a hamstring movement, but if you think about your glutes and are able to establish that mind-muscle connection, you'll definitely feel the burn. Then we moved on to the final exercise, which was a lying hamstring curl. This movement is honestly really difficult for me, and I prefer pretty much any other hamstring exercise, but you should always try to do more of what you suck at because that's the only way that you can get better at it. Side note, this machine was super cool and it actually counted your reps and time per set for you, so that's super high tech. But as you can see in these first couple of sets, you can kind of see my butt coming off of the pad and doing kind of like an inchworm thing, and that is wrong, so don't do that. But Brandon actually gave me a cue that really helped, and that was to think about squeezing my glutes before I curl, and that just ensures that my hips are fully in the pads and that I just use my hamstrings to move the weight. I also use a lot lighter weight than Emily on this one, and that is simply because my form does not allow me to go heavier yet. Eventually I'll be able to work my way up, but my advice is to always get good at the movement and feel comfortable with the form before you move up in weight. I cannot stress that enough. Like the other movements, I try to contract the working muscle really hard at the top and then do a slow, controlled eccentric. Here I just had to show you guys what it looks like behind the scenes of a cinematic edit filming. Emily posted the same exact workout on her channel, but it looks completely different. First of all, the clips are of her, and who doesn't want to watch Em work out? And it's also more of a cinematic, more entertainment style workout, so definitely go to her channel. It is linked below, but I just want to thank you guys for sticking around for this voiceover, and here's the rest of the vlog.
Alright guys, we had an epic leg workout, but we didn't want to make Brandon wait afterwards while we did our cardio, so we just got dropped off at the apartment gym, and we're about to do some biking. This post-cardio hair though, I literally have like a rat's nest because it was soaking up the sweat on my back. Isn't that really cute? Mm-hmm. But we are enjoying protein shakes now back at Em's house. And on the agenda for tonight is editing, emails, more protein ice cream concoctions, and probably the Mindy project, yes?
Yes.
So. Yes.
Sorry, that was really creepy.
Random voice from back. And we're just gonna hang with the dogs. Thor, come here. Say hi to my YouTube.
Go say hi.
Thor. Come here. Hey.
Food on his mind.
I'll introduce you guys to Thor at a later date, but I wanted to let y'all know that Emily filmed a different version of our workout. She is doing more of like a cinematic edit, kind of like my last workout footage that I posted. So hers can be like artsy entertainment style, where mine was a little more informational. So definitely go check out her channel. It's not going to be the same exact thing that you just saw. It's going to be Emily and all of her hotness being all cinematic. So make sure you go to her channel and hit the subscribe and like button as well, because she is awesome at the YouTube and just an awesome person in general. I also just wrote a really mushy friendship post on Instagram, so go read that too. Okay, I'll talk to you guys later when I put my life back together. Bye. The cutest little thing for Mama Nugget and Baby Nugget and the baby Nugget.
Hello.
Sorry I ruined your moment.
No, it's okay.
Hello. Family.
Hello to my little friend. His name is
Look at how big Thor is, you guys. Like, he's... You tell him, Conan. Say, those are my man bits.
You tell him.
Okay, second to last meal is this delicious looking quesadilla creation, which is a flat out wrap with the pork I showed you guys earlier, fajita veggies, and Mexican blend cheese and jalapenos, and it looks delicious. So I'm gonna eat this, do some editing and emails, and then it's time for my protein ice cream.
It's pretty good.
I wish y'all could see Emily in her natural habitat right now, sloughing on the couch with her giant bowl of protein ice cream. Don't look at me, I'm hideous. SpongeBob reference, anyone? But we are nomming on our protein ice cream. Same recipe that I always use. I just use Emily's protein instead of my usual PE science. And it has half a serving of Reese's Puffs on top. The Kroger off-brand Reese's Puffs that are equally as delicious as regular Reese's Puffs. And then I also have 3/4 of a serving, just like a poverty serving, but I put it in this really tiny bowl to make it seem like more. And I'm eating it with a baby spoon, so it basically looks like a big scoop, right? But anyways, it's 3/4 serving of this Tillamook Mudslide, which it's real ice cream, you guys. Like, look at those macros. 12 fat. Worth it, though. There's, like, a huge fudge ripple. I don't know if y'all can tell, but so good. So we're gonna have an ice cream party and watch the Mindy Project and go to bed. So exciting things coming tomorrow. I'll start a whole new vlog about that. But thank you guys for watching this one. Please give it a like, especially if you enjoyed the workout footage. Let me know below if you want more voiceover/informational workout stuff. I'd be happy to film that for y'all. Oh, and I've been loving ending my videos with little like prompts for you guys to answer in the comments because it's been really fun for me to read them. So for this video, comment with your favorite flavor of real ice cream, not diet ice cream, your favorite flavor of store-bought real ice cream that you like to get, because I like to expand my ice cream horizons. And Emily and Brandon want to know too. So thank you for watching. Love you guys. Goodbye. Mwah.